for example, tell you that when, as a broadcaster, you host a political contender, you must not allow them to use the platform to promote violence, to incite voters against a particular person, or to propagate tribalistic sentiments. In the last 2 weeks or so, we've had a few people who have been on radio and have been making a lot of statements that, in our view, border on actually promoting sectarianism. As we know, sectarianism is still illegal in Uganda, so this practice of positioning one tribe as good and another tribe as bad is not acceptable. We know the number of politicians who love using tribal orientations and attachments as the basis to propagate their political agenda. I think you've heard the Minister of ICT pronouncing herself that media should avoid allowing politicians to propagate tribalistic and sectarian tendencies. We call upon all of us to always restrain. Even when a politician comes and they're trying to campaign in a way that mudslides another person or positions one tribe against another, try to rein in on them. As a show host, call upon these people and tell them right before the show starts that they are not allowed to say anything that is tribalistic, that is likely to injure people's religious feelings, or likely to disharmonize society. Because at the end of the day, the media, we are supposed to be a public good that benefits everybody, not just the person that comes to our media houses, but the entire world. Because your radio stations are now listened to by people beyond your districts, by people beyond your country borders. Many of you are now broadcasting online. People are following you from all over the world. So you have a duty to ensure that you do not allow one politician in your area to use your radio to propagate campaigning that tends to show that maybe your region is marginalized, your region is unfairly treated, your region is not loved. That can create tribal sentiments that can end up causing bigger problems in our country. As many of us remember, in 2007 in Kenya, largely the fights and the death that resulted out of the election violence were as a result of the tribal sentiment that politicians were meting out through the media. We still remember what happens in Rwanda in 1994. The media was at the forefront in promoting the Hutu-Tutsi rivalry. So we call upon all of us as journalists to always be mindful of these limitations and try to call upon the people that come to our shows to exercise responsibility, to exercise personal restraint, even when they have personal feelings. It is okay for you as an individual to hate a particular tribe. It is okay. But it is illegal if you show and signify your tribal feelings on radio or TV. Because by doing so, you will be encouraging other people to do the same. And in doing so, we can end up having a national issue which can end up affecting not just your region, your tribe, but the entire country. And as regulators, our duty is to ensure that we all enjoy this country, we all protect this nation, because at the end of the day, we all have a duty to protect Uganda and make it habitable, peaceful, and harmonious for everybody. Ugandans, non-Ugandans, irrespective of their tribes, irrespective of their religions, irrespective of their political orientation. There are so many other laws that I may not have touched on, but maybe also let me draw your attention to the Uganda Communications Content Regulations of 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, in 2019, the Minister of ICT exercised his powers under Section 93 of the UCC Act and issued a number of regulations. These regulations were gazetted. They are available in the public libraries. Some of them are also available online. We call upon all of us to read them and the journalists to draw the attention of the public to these regulations, because these regulations provide for a number of issues that are good for consumers, good for operators and the entire public. So for purposes of our discussion today, I've singled out the content regulations of 2019. They specifically guide broadcasters on how their programming should be, how their content should be structured. And in doing all this, we are trying to ensure that the broadcasters are guided, to ensure that their content is in line with the law and the standards. But also, in these content regulations, there are certain offenses that were created, especially when you look at Regulation 45. There are certain offenses where, for example, we say that any person who broadcasts content that is prohibited under this regulation commits an offense and is liable on conviction to a fine not exceeding 4 tight currency points or imprisonment not exceeding a term of 2 years or both. Now, in this regulation, the number of things, the offenses that you could possibly commit include where you, with respect to political advertisement, where you come up with a political advert or you have political discussions that are contrary to, for example, the Parliamentary Elections Act. You allow somebody to record something and they play it on your radio that is promoting sectarianism, that is promoting tribalism, or that is encouraging commission of other offenses like incitement to violence. All those are not acceptable.